Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. If you are one of my subscribers, you know that a lot of my videos focus on teaching you how to be a freelancer on Upwork.com. I'm a top-rated plus freelancer on Upwork and have earned over $80,000 since I started promoting my services on Upwork. And when I started, I was a complete beginner. So the most important thing when you're trying to look for a job on Upwork is to apply to the right kind of jobs. If you just apply to any job that you see, you're going to waste all of your connects and you only get a certain amount to use for free each month. And also it's really exhausting to apply to dozens and dozens of jobs and never get hired. So in this video, I'm going to teach you how to filter through and find the right jobs for you so you have a higher chance of getting hired. Of course, the most important thing is to have a great profile and portfolio. So if you want to learn how to make a great profile, I will link you to my video in the description below. But in this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to search for the right kind of jobs and how to search for beginner-friendly jobs as well when you're just getting started. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one, and let's get started. Okay, so here we are on Upwork.com. So once you log into your freelancer account, you can see that Upwork has changed it a little bit on how you search for jobs. So we have two different options. First of all, at the top, if you click on this arrow, make sure that you have selected jobs. If you are looking to hire a freelancer, you can click talent or you can click projects to browse and buy projects. But I'm assuming that you are looking to get hired as a freelancer, so make sure that jobs is selected. Now you can either search for jobs up here or on this search bar right here. And if you scroll down, you'll see that based on your previous search history, you can look at best matches for jobs you might like, most recent, or any saved jobs that you may have saved. Now let's say that you're just starting out as a freelancer and you do not know what kind of jobs you want to apply to. Or if you can't get hired for the job in your field, let's say you're a virtual assistant and you're not getting hired for any virtual assistant jobs, I'm going to show you some tips on how you can get some feedback on your profile and how you can search for jobs that are more likely to hire you. So first of all, let's just browse to see what kinds of jobs are available. We can just click on the search icon without typing anything in. And this is going to bring us to the search system. As you can see here, there are almost 200,000 jobs available on Upwork. A lot of people have said to me, well, can I really get hired on Upwork when I don't live in the US? Because there are a lot of jobs that are US only. Well, I do not live in the US. I'm a Canadian citizen and I don't have access to any of the US jobs unless someone sends me an interview. So this is 200,000 jobs that I am seeing as someone who's not in the US. So if you do live in the US, you will have access to even more jobs. Okay, so you could start going down and scrolling through all of these jobs and seeing what's available, but obviously we want to narrow this down because there's 200,000 jobs. So over here, you can filter by category. And there are all sorts of different categories: accounting and consulting, admin support, customer service, data science and analytics. So you could go through and see all of the different categories available. So for me, for example, I work in the design and creative industry. So I could go ahead and click on any of these: voice talent, video and animation. But let's say I want to see all of the jobs available in design and creative. I'm going to click on all design and creative. So now that's narrowed it down to 36,000 jobs that are available right now. Over here on the side, you can sort by experience level. So let's say you are a graphic designer, you have a lot of experience. When you're trying to establish a reputation on Upwork, I don't recommend you saying right off the bat that you're an expert, because you sort of have to establish that you are an expert by having some feedback from clients on your profile. So I recommend searching for entry level and intermediate jobs to start. And later on, you can apply to the expert level jobs once you have a bit of experience on Upwork. So the next filter we have is job type. You can search either by hourly jobs or fixed price. Now I have a video on the difference between hourly and fixed price. Basically, hourly, you get paid per hour, and a fixed price means you get paid one set fee for the entire job. Because we're going to imagine we're just starting out, we're trying to get our first job, we're going to leave both of these blank, because we want to see all the jobs available to us. Next, we have number of proposals. Now, this is how many people are bidding on the job or trying to get a job interview. So we don't want to apply for jobs that have too many proposals, especially if we're just starting out. Because I am currently a top-rated plus freelancer, I will apply for jobs sometimes that are 20 to 50 or more proposals. But if you're just starting out, you don't want to compete with people who have a lot of experience. So let's put less than 5, 5 to 10, and 10 to 15. Now next, under client info, we can look for any of our jobs by our previous clients or clients that are payment verified. So currently with these filters, we have 14,000 jobs that are available to us. But if we click on payment verified, that is reduced now to over 8,000 jobs. Now you can apply to a job with a client who is not payment verified and have them verify their payment before you start working with them. However, I like to work with payment verified clients or apply to jobs that are payment verified already because that does show that the client is serious. They're not just browsing. They do want to hire someone and they've filled in all their payment information and they are ready to go. The next one is client history. Now, sometimes if you're starting out and you want to be really careful with your connects and you don't want to waste your connects and spend them wisely, you might want to go with clients that have already hired people. And that way you know for sure that the client is familiar with Upwork, that they have experience hiring. However, I have also worked with clients that have never hired anyone before and I have been their first voiceover artist or video editor that they've worked with and they have gone on to hire me again and again. So this is up to you. Maybe you want to work with a client who already has experience on Upwork or maybe you don't mind. You can set a client location. I have worked with clients worldwide, so I just leave this blank. And then we also have project length. So if you're looking for a more long-term job, you can select something like 3 to 6 months, more than 6 months, and also how many hours per week you want the job to be if you're looking for something more ongoing. We're going to leave all of this blank because we want to see as many options as possible. So now even with all those filters, we still have 8,000 jobs available. So we're obviously going to want to narrow it down even more. So what we can do is click on advanced search. And this lets us search for certain keywords of the types of jobs that we're looking for. So let's say I am looking for graphic design jobs. You can type in here all of these words or any of these words. I'm going to type in graphic design under any of these words. And also thumbnails, because I'm seeing a lot of these YouTube thumbnail jobs available. I do have a video on how to create YouTube thumbnails as well if you're interested that you can see in the description below. So now let's press search, and what that will do is it will search for any jobs that have graphic or design or thumbnails. So I want to narrow this down even more. I'm going to just type in thumbnails so we can see if there's any jobs about creating YouTube thumbnails for people. And you can see there's 145 jobs found. So this is a really popular skill because there are so many YouTube channels and a lot of YouTubers don't want to create their own thumbnails. And so once you find a job that you want to apply to, like let's look at this one for example. You can see they want 100 thumbnails needed for their YouTube channel. Or this one, thumbnails of YouTube, they want, they're going to pay $12 for 30 thumbnails, which of course it's not a lot of money, but this would be the type of job you could do to sort of get started and get client feedback. So let's say we like a few of these jobs and we want to save them to apply to later. We can click on this little heart icon and that will save this job into our saved jobs as well. And so then the next time you open up Upwork, you can go here under saved jobs and all the jobs that we saved are now here, the ones that we clicked the heart on. So let's say I wanted to apply to this job here. I can click on the title and this will pop up more information about the job. I do have an in-depth tutorial on how to apply to job and how to write a cover letter. But when you're applying to a job, I definitely recommend you apply to the job as quickly as possible. I have seen jobs that I know I'm qualified for, but they've been up for about a week. They have over 20 or 50 proposals. And I know had they seen my portfolio earlier, they might have hired me, but I'm sure they've gone through so many different applications already. So this person, for example, they posted this job 2 hours ago. And if you scroll down here, you can see that this job was last viewed by the client 1 minute ago. So right now they are looking at their proposals. So this would be a perfect time to send in your proposal because this client is active, they're online, they're looking at the options available to them. So when you want to apply to a job, you click submit a proposal. And you can propose with a specialized profile if you have a special one for graphic design, for example. And then you put in how much you're willing to bid for the job. So this one, for example, they had it set at $12. So another tip I have for you, if you are trying to get your first job, do not overbid. If someone is saying, we want someone to do this job, for example, for $12, don't say that you're going to do it for $20. Meet them at $12 or even offer your services a little bit less, because obviously if a person is trying to get the best deal, they might hire a freelancer who is going to set in a lower bid. So if you're willing to do the same job for $10, put in $10. Obviously, you don't want to undersell yourself, but when you're first starting out, you will be doing jobs for less than what you normally charge. When I was first doing voiceover jobs, I was often doing them for $20, and now I would charge much more than that. You write how long the project will take you, and then you write out your cover letter and attach any files or any proof or a portfolio of your work so they can get an idea of the types of YouTube thumbnails you've created in the past, for example. Again, I have a tutorial on how to write a proposal and how to write a cover letter, which I will link to in the description below. So again, make sure that you are applying to jobs as quickly as possible to get a better chance of being hired. Now, if you want to save this search to look for again, you can click here on Save Search. So let's type in entry level YouTube thumbnails. That's my search. I'm going to click Save. And now the next time we log on Upwork, right here, you can just click on the search that you've saved. So let's say you're searching for different types of jobs. You don't have to go through and put all those filters. You can just click entry-level YouTube thumbnails, and all of the filters that we had previously set, they will be here for us. And you can see all the different jobs or new jobs that are available that match all of the criteria we specified. So let's say that you cannot get a job on Upwork in your field. You just can't get a job on Upwork. You don't know what to do. You know you need to get feedback in order for people to hire you, but you can't get any jobs. Well, this is when I recommend you branching out of your field and trying to get any sort of job. Doesn't matter what job it is. If you can start building a reputation on Upwork and start getting feedback, people are more likely to hire you if you have been hired successfully by someone else, even if it is in a different job field. So I do voiceovers on Upwork and also video editing. But when I first was starting out on Upwork, I did some writing jobs, I did some proofreading jobs, and I started getting 5-star feedback. And when people see that you are a 5-star rated freelancer, they're more likely to hire you. So what you can do is when you're searching for a job, let's just click the search icon again without any filters. And of these 200,000 jobs found, what we can do is click on advanced search. And under any of these words, we're going to type in beginners and beginner. And what that will do is it's going to search for any jobs that have beginners or beginner. So we have 493 jobs found. Let's click on entry level to reduce it now to 98 jobs. And every day I recommend you going on to Upwork and searching for things like beginners, beginners welcome, new freelancers. And if you search for keywords like this, you'll find different clients that are willing to hire pretty much anyone. They just want to pay the minimum amount of money possible in order to get the work done. So if you take on some simple jobs like that, even if they are jobs that are outside of your field, for example, proofreading, translation, writing, or simple video editing jobs, anything that you think you can do, if you see a job that you think you can do, just apply to the job and send in a sample of your work. I often see a lot of different jobs like this one here, app store reviews. This person's willing to pay just for reviews of their app or maybe a video testimonial. Simple jobs like this that you can do and you don't have to have any skill or experience. You might have to do these jobs for a low amount of money, but the most important thing is to be building your portfolio and to get feedback on your portfolio. Okay, everyone, so that is it for my tutorial on how to search for jobs on Upwork. Again, I just encourage you to be persistent, keep applying for jobs, follow all the steps in my videos on how to apply for jobs and how to write a cover letter, and just make sure you fill out your portfolio. The most important thing is to be consistent, apply to the right kind of jobs, and apply as fast as you can. It took me a while to get my first job, and then after my first job, I got my second and third, and it just kept growing and growing and growing. And as you can see here, I've now done over 227 jobs, and I'm ongoing working with many of my different clients. Thank you guys once again for watching. And if you have any other questions about Upwork, just leave me a comment in the comment section below. Thank you guys once again, and I'll see you in my next video.